Hey there, it's Wednesday, July 24th, and today's title is Walking with the Lord. As we near the end of the book of Psalms, the exclamations of praise seem to grow in crescendo after crescendo. The final five Psalms begins with a simple and direct command to praise the Lord. But the first of these, Psalms 146, has a particular focus on God's concern for the poor and oppressed as primarily reason for such a praise. As surely as God is creator of the world, this psalm describes God's continuing work in the world as judge, provider, liberator, healer, helper, and defender. All of these focused on people in specific need of these kinds of help. It is an inspiring vision of what God does and seeks to do in our lives, in our communities, and in our world. Sometimes we think of caring for the needy as something we ought to do because God said so. But Psalms 146 says this is something God already does, and we are invited to join with Him. When we work against poverty, oppression, and disease, we are truly working with God and His purposes. What greater privilege can there be than partnering with God in fulfilling something as inspiring as Psalms 146? But there are also benefits for us. Christians often talk about their search for God and their desire to have a closer relationship with Him. Yet verses like Psalms 146, 7 through 9, and so many others throughout the Bible indicate to us that one way to find God is to join with what He does. So if He is working to uplift the poor, sick, and oppressed, as Psalms 146 says, He is, we should be working with Him as well. Christ came to this earth to walk and work among the poor and suffering. They received the greatest share of His attention. And today, in the person of His children, He visits the poor and needy, relieving woe and alleviating suffering. Take away suffering and need, and we should have no way of understanding the mercy and love of God, no way of knowing the compassionate, sympathetic Heavenly Father. Never does the gospel put on an aspect of greater loveliness than when it is brought to the most needy and destitute regions. Ellen G. White, Testimonies to the Church. What has been your experience in how we become close to God by serving others? Please answer in the comment section below. Thank you for watching as always. God bless you, and please continue to pray for our ministry and serve others in the community.